I am the bunny who hides your eggs and leaves you the sweetest treats. As I flippity flop and hippity hop with my big bunny feet. With my big long ears and my little pink nose, I'll be hopping down your street. But the only thing I ask for is a little privacy.
Excuse me.
Ashley gets buttercups, Amy gets peeps, and Amanda gets a bag of dried meat. Sam gets a card game, George gets a mermaid, and Sean gets a fresh new beat. That's because I don't have a naughty list, so you're all good with me. Just as long as you give me a little privacy.
Whew, it's hot today.
My marshmallows, jelly beans, and lollipops all make kids go ballistic. But it wouldn't be the same without a chocolate bunny. If you don't believe, then don't get mad at me when the Easter bunny doesn't leave a basket. Because if you do, then I'll put you... This year is extra special for all you special kids. Easter is on 420. Who knows what 420 is? I made chocolate brownies and Rice Krispie bars. This year's better than the last. So have a happy holiday and enjoy that Easter grass. Yes, have a happy holiday. Yes, have a happy holiday.
I don't get paid for this. This is slavery.
Yes, have a
One fine day as I was walking down the street, spied a beggar man with rags upon his feet. Took a penny from my pocket in his tin cup, I did drop it. And I heard him say as I made my retreat, "May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May an elephant caress you with his toes. In her hose. May the bird of paradise fly up your nose." My laundry man is really on his toes. Found a $100 bill among my clothes. When he called me, I came running, gave him back his dime for phoning. And I heard him saying as I turned to go, "May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May an elephant caress you with his toes. May your wife be flagged with runners in her hose. May the bird of paradise fly up your nose." I was way behind one day to catch a train. The taxi driver said, "We'll make it just the same." A speed cop made it with us, and as he wrote out the ticket, I stood by politely waiting for my change. "May the bird of paradise fly up your nose. May an elephant caress you with his toes.
Thank you. Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons, a number 9 coal. And the straw boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble are my middle name. I was raised in the canebrake by an old mama line. Can't no high-toned woman make me walk the line. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John,
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, he kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from New Orleans, where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen. And a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John,
Big John.
Then came the day at the bottom of the mine when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast, and everybody thought that they'd breathe their last, except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made hell walked a giant of a man that the miners knew well. Grabbed a sagging timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant oak tree just stood there alone. Big John,
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John,
Big John.
And with all of his strength he gave a mighty shove. Then a miner yelled out, "There's a light up above!" And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. And now there's only one left down there to save Big John. With jacks and timbers they started back down. Then came that rumble way down in the ground. And the smoke and gas belched out of that mine. Everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John, Big John,
Big Bad John,
Big John,
Now they never reopened that worthless pit, they just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words are written on that stand: at the bottom of this mine lies a big, big man. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big bad John.
Big John.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to
was the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings all hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all safe in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With the little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, as he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, now Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of his pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round little belly.